we're going to find the best projects and the best entrepreneurship and the best social impact and the best things that are changing the island and changing the country and changing the cities within the island and the country. And we're going to create amazing, beautiful content around that. But it's going to all be created, produced, directed by the kids. West, take your business north. See you soon, Colorado. I mean, I actually think that this has the potential to literally be one of the world's most beautiful projects ever. It's the kind of project that I think Ellen or Oprah or whoever the next Oprah is that comes into it will feature as one of these things. I mean, so just really quickly, the idea that we have is empowering orphaned children, and I don't like that word orphaned children, but like for clarification, it's these same kids that I fell in love with in the Dominican Republic 11 years ago, where I said I'm going to dedicate my whole life to this community, these same kids are going to be the ones that basically run the entire Fulbright Project, meaning we're going to find the best projects and the best entrepreneurship and the best social impact and the best things that are changing the island and changing the country and changing the cities within the island and the country, and we're going to create amazing, beautiful content around that. But it's going to all be created, produced, directed by the kids. I mean, we're going to direct the kids. But the thing that I think is going to be most amazing about this is that, you know, and I don't know if this is necessarily just a thing if you're an orphan or what, but society is always telling these kids, like, just be grateful. Like, just keep it cool. Be grateful someone rescued you. Be grateful that you have food on your table. Be grateful you have a roof over your head. All true things. But I think that what I'm really, really passionate about is, like, I don't want them to just be grateful that they have food and chill out. Because I think that they didn't choose to be thrown on the side of the street. They didn't choose to be sold into sex slavery at age 7. They didn't choose to be tied to a bed and burned with fire. They didn't choose to be tied to a couch while their mom went out for 12 hours a day and tried to find food or try to find money for her own drug problem. I mean, there's so much there. There's so much behind what happened before these kids got rescued, and these kids didn't choose that, right? So it's like they didn't choose to not have a chance to actually be huge players and tastemakers and changers in the world. And so I think that that's what we're going to show them, which is, I don't want you to just play safe. I don't want you to just be grateful for your food. You know the best way you can be grateful for your food? Figure out how to create something so powerful that it feeds 10,000 other people. The best way for you to be grateful for the roof over your head is find a way to build roofs for 100,000 other people. The best way for you to be grateful that you have mentors in your life is to be a mentor to 15 other people. I believe in that. I don't believe in just like, okay, now I'm grateful, now I'm gonna chill. I believe in, I'm grateful, I'm gonna create. And so I think that if we can show these kids that, and I know that it's gonna be possible. And I was like literally woke up this morning crying, because I think that, you know, it's so fun for me to do this documentation stuff, because I'm 35 now. What we're gonna create over the next 30, 40, 50 years is literally going to just be unbelievable. I mean, I don't think anyone has any idea how much we have in us, all of us. And so I want to tell these kids, and I'm going to show these kids, and what starts with 4, 6, or 10, or however, whatever number we start with in the new year, could literally become a worldwide movement where you, the one that everyone's telling to just be grateful and chill out and stay within the lines of society, and you were given a chance. No, you actually have the chance to be the one that changes everything, to be the one that shows the beauty of your country or the beauty of the land or the beauty of the entrepreneurship, or to become the entrepreneur yourselves that changes everything, to become the person that the 13-year-old orphan that lives in Santo Domingo looks at and says, well, if this guy or this gal who's now 35 could do it, so could I. And I'm gonna talk to them, I'm gonna pick their brain, I'm gonna watch what they did. And I think that when that happens, then we've really created something meaningful. And I think for me, the whole hope, the entire hope, just like the whole hope behind Uniting the Americas was to get people to start that take that first step or that fifth step or that 144th step or that final step to live the life that they really want to live on their terms and with their dream and their passion projects. Just like that was the goal of that. And then obviously bringing the two people. The goal of this is to change the mentality of these kids who have been told, you are lucky, you have been chosen to be rescued, so be grateful. I want to say, sure, you're lucky. And yes, I have immense respect for the person that gave you the chance. Now I want to ask you, what are you going to do with it? What are you going to do with that chance? And I want to push you as hard as I possibly can out of every comfort zone, out of every learning that you've ever been told, so that you can get to a place where you become indestructible, you become unstoppable, you become the one that changes the entire world. Not because you're lucky and you should be grateful, but because you have it in you already, and now it's time to do something about it. So I want to help you empower yourself to do something about it. And that is why I'm starting this project and the documentation behind it. Because I want everyone in the world to see that no matter where you came from, no matter what circumstances you have, no matter what life dealt you, you are in control of what you do with it. And what you do with it can be good and powerful and meaningful and a change maker and absolutely the biggest gift that you could give yourself and your country and your world is to fully tap into, believe in, and then utilize your power. That's what we're going to do in the Dominican Republic. That's how we're going to use the Fulbright. It's going to be a content creation piece that's going to end up in the Dominican Film Festival of New York City. I'm sure about that. It's going to turn into a documentary piece that's going to inspire people all over the world, millions of people all over the world. I'm sure about that. It's going to leave a ripple. I'm sure about that. It's going to inspire the people to think creatively about passion projects, about things that they can do. I'm sure about that. But more than anything, what I'm really sure about is that one of you that participates in this project, whether it's this Fulbright in 2019 or whether it's something in 2051, one of you that participates is going to have that unlock, that click, that moment that says, oh shit, I actually have this in me. And it's not enough to just be grateful and chill and play within the lines and listen to everything that society tells me that I should do. I actually have a fire inside of me that is desperate to get out into the world and light the rest of the world on fire. It's my time to do it. And now finally someone has given me permission, has shown me the route, has given me the guide map, has given me the resources, and now it's time for me to go. That's what I want to do. That's what we're going to do. From October in sunny Boulder with the beautiful blue skies and the Rocky Mountains to wherever you're watching this episode, I hope that you realize that you have it inside of you. You can do it. There is no one stopping you. It might appear that there is someone stopping you. There is no one, and I do mean no one stopping you. And if you need me to be the one to push you, I will gladly push, and I will keep pushing you, and I will keep pushing you, and I will keep pushing you, and hopefully we can push together and work together, and I look forward to that. But if I cannot work with you in person, if I do not have the chance to meet you in person, as I look you directly down the skull of this camera, I want you to understand something. I believe in you. I believe in your capacity. I believe in your ability. I believe in your talent. You have to believe in yourself. Give yourself that gift. Give the world that gift. And watch what happens. Here's what I can promise you. It will be glorious.